When it comes to patients that are needing some sort of anesthetic during their dental procedure, but they're also pregnant, there's a couple things we want to consider. The first one is, ideally we want to do any dental treatment during the second trimester. The first trimester, there's so much development happening, we just don't want to disrupt anything. Really, the research shows that it's probably okay, and especially if a patient is in pain, it's probably okay to do, but it's always better to err on the side of safety. You also could avoid the third trimester if you could, because it's just more uncomfortable for the patient to lay back for long periods of time. So ideally, the best time to do any treatment is the second trimester if the patient needs any care. But really, they can come to your hygiene visit at any point if they feel comfortable with it, if their OB says it's fine, and if they're in pain, for sure we want to see them. The second thing is, if you give any anesthetic, you want to be careful what you give. So there's different pregnancy classifications, right? A, B, C. C, a lot of our local anesthetics, like septicane, is a C, so we don't want to use that. A lidocaine, though, is B. So if you have to give local anesthetic, lidocaine is the best for our pregnant patients. Another thing is benzocaine, our topical anesthetic, which has benzocaine, is a pregnancy class C. So we don't want to use any topical with our patients. Again, it's localized. I mean, it probably be okay, but the research shows it's C, so we should definitely do the best for our patients and not be using topical with them. Also comes with our topicals that we use subgingivally. Double check and see what's in your subgingival topical that you place. So if you use gingicane, it is just benzocaine. So if you're using any kind of benzocaine subgingivally, we want to stay away from that for our pregnancy patients.